Dear students, this is Sir Mohsin. Today I am going to teach you grammar topic, that is finite and non-finite verbs, from your English book 3 grammar section, page number 116. Dear students, as you can see, your book Understand and Communicate, an English course for secondary school, book 3 revised edition, section grammar, lesson number 1, finite and non-finite verbs. Dear students, as you have studied about verb in your previous classes, so today we will discuss about finite and non-finite verbs. Here you can see what is a verb. A verb can appear in 5 different forms: the root or base form, the S form, the past tense, the present participle, and the past participle. Here are some examples: do, does, did, doing, done. The first 3 forms are finite in the sense that they are complete as predicate verbs in sentences. So here are some examples. Number 1 example, I do the work. Number 2nd example, she does the work. Number 3rd example, we did the work. So do and does in 1st and 2nd are the present tense forms. Did in example 3 is the past tense forms. Dear students, verb is mainly divided into 2 parts, main verb and auxiliary verb. So in this lesson, we will discuss finite and non-finite verbs. So let's get started. Here is the question, what is a finite verb? Basically, finite verb is a verb that has a finite or limited agreement with the subject. What does it mean? It limits its usage as per subject's parameter. There are 3 defined parameters on which this is limitation is fixed. First is tense, that is subject is performing action in past, present or future. And second, person, that is the subject is first person, second person or the third person. And third is the number, that is subject is singular or plural. So a finite verb will change as per tense of the sentences, as per tense of the sentence, as per person or as per number of the subject. So dear students, as you can see, I have drawn a chart for you so you can easily understand the chart. Now let's understand each of these parameters with the help of examples. So here are some headings with examples. As you can see, verb change as per tense. So as we know that when we change tense, so you have to use the correct form of the verb. So here are some examples. Number 1, I play cricket every day. So this is in present tense. When we change into past, so it becomes played. I played cricket every day. So this is past tense. So verb changes as per tense. So they are finite verbs. Second heading is verb change as per person. As you can see, first person, second person, third person. So here are examples. I run a mile daily. When we change, he runs a mile daily. So they are finite verbs. And the third heading is verb change as per number, either it is singular or plural. Apple is of red color. And second one, apples are of red color. As we change the subject is singular, so we use is. When the subject is plural, so we use are. So they are finite verbs. So they change as per tense, as per person and as per number. But they all are finite verbs. Now let's talk about non-finite verbs. What is the non-finite verb? So non-finite verbs don't have agreement with the subject. It does not change with the tense, it does not change with the number, and it does not change with the person. So here are some examples. There is a sentence, I found his office at a walking distance. And the second sentence, Adnan will find office at a walking distance. So here, walking is a non-finite verb. As you can see, the first sentence found and the second sentence is the main verb is find. Found and find are finite verbs, but the walking, that is non-finite verb, because it does not perform any action in this sentence. Now you can see here the chart do not function as verb. So non-finite verbs do not function as verb. So it functions as adjective, as a noun, or as an adverb. So here are some examples. Number one, the sleeping cat is brown. So here sleeping is an adjective. The second one, running is a good habit. So running is a noun in this sentence. And the third sentence, Alia went to the UK to study. So here study is an adverb. So now we have come to know that non-finite verbs work as an adjective, as a noun, or as an adverb. Now let's talk about the division of non-finite verbs. So non-finite verbs are divided into three kinds. Number one, gerund. Number two, infinitive. Number three, participle. So here are examples. Example number one, I want to write a letter. So here to is infinitive. The second sentence, make him apologize quickly. So there is infinitive without to. The third sentence, I like playing games. So here playing is gerund. So there is a note you have to understand. Although the participles doing and done are non-finite, but the verbs formed by adding auxiliaries to these participles are finite. Thus, is, are, was, were, doing, and has, have, had, done, and is, are, was, were, done, are finite. So when we add auxiliaries with doing and done, so they become finite. But doing and done are non-finite. Hopefully you have understood. Now dear students, this is your home assignment. You have to solve exercise 1, 2 and 3 from your book, page number 117 and 118. Okay, see you next time with another lecture. Allah Hafiz. Goodbye.